In this question, we have been given three capacitors C1, C2 and C3, and these three capacitors are arranged in this fashion. So here we have been given the values of these capacitors as well as the breakdown voltages. And we have been asked to find the maximum safe voltage which can be applied across this combination as well as the corresponding total charge which is stored across this combination. And here we have been given these four options. So here we have been given that C1 is equal to 10 microfarad, C2 is equal to 5 microfarad and C3 is equal to 2 microfarad. And corresponding breakdown voltages are 10 volt, 5 volt and 2 volts. Now over here, this capacitor C2 and C3 are connected in series. It means that the charge that is stored across this capacitor should be equal, or we can say that Q2 will be equal to Q3. Now we know that the stored charge is equal to C times voltage V. So we can say that C2 times V2 will be equal to C3 times V3. Now over here, let us assume that the voltage across this capacitor C3 is equal to the maximum voltage which can be applied across this capacitor, that is 2 volt. And assuming that, let us find out the value of this voltage V2. So the value of V2 will be equal to C3 by C2 times this voltage V3. Or we can say that voltage V2 will be equal to 2 by 5 times 2 volt, that is equal to 0.8 volt. So from this we can say that whenever the voltage across this capacitor C3 is 2 volt, then to have a same charge, the value of voltage V2 across this capacitor C2 should be equal to 0.8 volt. Now over here, if we assume the value of V2 as 5 volt, and correspondingly suppose if we find the value of this voltage across this capacitor, then the value of that voltage V3 will be more than the breakdown voltage of this capacitor. So over here, we will assume that the value of V3 is equal to 2 volt, and correspondingly the value of V2 is equal to 0.8 volt. So the total voltage across this two terminal will be equal to V1 plus V2, that is equal to 2.8 volt. And the same voltage will also appear across this capacitor C1. And as you can see over here, this total voltage 2.8 volt is less than the breakdown voltage of this capacitor C1. So this will be the effective voltage which will appear across this capacitor combination. Now let us find out the total charge across this combination. Now like I said, the total charge Q will be equal to C times V, where C is the equivalent capacitance of this combination and V is the voltage which is appearing between these two terminals. So first of all, let us find out the equivalent capacitance of this combination. So here the C equivalent will be equal to C1 plus the parallel combination of C2 and C3. Or we can say that C equivalent will be equal to 10 microfarad plus parallel combination of 5 and 2 microfarad capacitors. So C equivalent will be equal to 10 plus 5 into 2 divided by 5 plus 2. Or we can say that C equivalent will be equal to 80 by 7 microfarad. And here the voltage across this two terminal is equal to 2.8 volt. So the total charge which is stored across this combination will be equal to 80 by 7 times 2.8 volt, which is equal to 32 microcoulomb. So this will be the total charge which is stored across this combination. So for the given question, D is the correct answer.